What's up, everybody? Welcome to Money Management Channel. My name is Andrei, and today I'm going to be doing analysis on CHPT stock. First of all, brief information about this company. ChargePoint Holdings Incorporated is a EV charging network provider, which is committed to enabling the electrification of mobility of all people and goods. It's envisioned a new way of fueling conveniently located where drivers live, work and play. And let me give you some information about their financials. Their total market cap for now is $7.73 billion. And on March 11th, they report fourth quarter and fiscal 2020 financial results. Fiscal year 2021 revenue of $146 million exceeding forecast. Completed business combination with Switchbank Energy Acquisition Corporation began trading on New York Stock Exchange on March the 1st, 2021. Increased total cash balance to $615 million at the close of the business combination to fund growth initiatives. And let's dive deep into their financials. Revenue for the fourth quarter that ended January 31st, 2021, revenue was $42.4 million compared to $43.2 million in fourth quarter of the prior year period. For the fiscal year that ended January 31st, revenue was $146.5 million, up from $144.5 million in the prior year period. Fourth quarter GAAP gross margin was 21%, up from 20.4% in the prior year's fourth quarter. Fiscal year 2021 GAAP gross margin was 22.5%, a 10 percentage point improvement over gross margin of 12.5% in the prior year period. They have a net loss of $90.7 million compared to $33.8 million in the fourth quarter of the prior year, primarily due to a change in the fair value of the company's redeemable convertible preferred stock warrant liability. Fiscal year GAAP net loss was $197 million compared to $134.3 million in the prior year period, primarily reflecting the fiscal fourth quarter warrant change. They have, as I already mentioned, $615 million on cash. Let me quote their 2022 fiscal guidance. ChargePoint provides guidance based on current market conditions and expectations. For the first quarter ending April 30, 2021, which typically experience seasonally lower network station sales compared to the fourth quarter, ChargePoint expects revenue of $35 to $40 million. The company expects revenue for fiscal 2022 of $195 to $205 million, consistent with its previously published estimates and representing 37% year-over-year growth at the midpoint. And I think their financials are great, and I think you have to decide whether or not you be a part of this amazing company. Just a couple of facts. We are on their website and we are on a section about. And as you might see, someone plugs in every 2 seconds. Access to hundreds of thousands of places to charge with one account. 89.6 million charges delivered and counting. 60% of Fortune 15 companies are ChargePoint customers. 175 partners amplify our efforts. And you can read all the information about this company by yourself. Just think of this company like this. If you want to bet on different EV manufacturers like Tesla or NIO or XPeng, you have to decide whether or not you invest in this company. But this company has a competitive advantage that no matter who win the race on EV market producers, I mean EV cars producers, this company will benefit from all of the market. And they are literally the first company that started to make this business as a service 13 years ago. As you can see, they have 13 plus years in business. Years before you could buy a mass market EV, ChargePoint gave birth to a new way of fueling. So I think this company has a great potential, and I think you have to at least put this company into your watch list. And before we dive deep into the technical analysis, please subscribe to my channel with the notification bell. Only in this case you won't miss my next video. and hit the like button. It helps me a lot. So we have this weird price action, and here is my Elliott wave breakdown. Here is our first wave, and we have a 5-wave structure. It is a diagonal. Here is our third wave, and here is our fifth wave. And these three waves implies to a greater scale structure like this. Let me turn off these three waves for now. As you can see, we have this is the first wave, second, third, fourth, and fifth. And on a greater scale, we have this structure. So this is only the first wave. As you can see right here, we have the first wave. Here is the retracement second one, third wave, fourth and fifth, to be determined in the future. So, and let me show you this structure as a retracement. In my opinion, we have something like this, and it is a zigzag, and in my opinion, we've already hit the bottom for the second wave. We have completed 5 waves in a C wave. That's why I think it is the bottom of the third wave. And let me show you the retracement. So from the bottom to the top, I pulled the Fibonacci retracement tool, and here you can see the top of the wave. And as you can see, we hit 0.65, 0.618 region. It is the most probable zone of trend reversal, and we poke through this level. And it is a mixed sign, because we can even go lower a little bit. But in my opinion, because of this bounce and because of this particular candle, as you can see, it is a hammer, and it has a good volume, rather good volume. And green, each and every green candle has a greater volume than the any other red ones, except this candle, this last red candle. And in my opinion, it is a very good sign for the company from the technical standpoint. And that's why I think you might consider to enter your long position as an investor or even as a trader. But you have two possibilities. If you are an investor, you just add your position right here, and you can lower your buys whenever you want. But if you are loading your position as a trader, you have to put your stop loss right below this previous pivot point. And it will be rather big stop loss. Let me show it to you. About 30%, but it's your choice. If you want to invest just by this level, and you can lower your buys down right here at 0.786 region, or even lower. But I don't think that we might go lower because of this previous support slash resistance. And let me show it to you. And that's why this is to my main accumulation points right here at the opening hours, and to the 0.65 level, and then next will be right here. And let me define the targets of the third wave, and it will be a long-term play. Let me clean a little bit the chart. So here is the Fibonacci extension tool, and I put the first point from the bottom of the whole structure, second one at the top of the wave, as you can see, and the third point at the retracement of this wave. Let me remind you that on a greater scale we have this structure, and it is only the first wave on a greater scale. And let me define the targets. So according to Elliott wave theory, the most probable ratio first and third waves is 1.618. And here is this target. And second target might be even higher depending on the bullish sentiment, and it might be at 2.618 level. But let me suggest you to have this target for now, and in the future I will do an update, and then we will define is it possible to hit 2.618 region with the third wave, or we might have some retracement. But for now, the most probable zone of the third wave is 0.618 region, and this target give you an opportunity to have around 200% of potential profit. And in my opinion, it is a very, very legit and very viable target. And if you like my video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done this before. And for now, that's it. See you guys and girls next time. Bye.